so I'm gonna stay and put it all on the line. Sacrifice my life so I go hard till I die. No love for the little bitch. Screaming that they looking for a real nigga. Get a real one, gotta keep it real with you. Bet you get home and I wanna get real, can you, yeah? Dipping, dodging different problems. Gotta cheat that penal body. Then they not to get the flowers. Then I hit her in the shower. This ain't much, but this is almost. I won't switch, I get new power. They got ghosts, but I need Tasha, yeah. Hey, God, hey, God, tell me, is it real? Tell me if you love me, then tell me how you feel. Hey, God, hey, God, tell me what you know. Once I get the baby, you know everything's a go. I was up all night, trying to make it right. All that I could say is I'ma make a way.
Hold me down.
Listen,
real
man.
Niggas need love too. Cause real niggas need love. Real niggas need love. Real niggas need love too.
Yeah, they do.
They do. Real niggas
man,
need
listen,
love.
Man, that's Lights, Camera, man, straight out of Philadelphia, man. Need love, but right now you're now tuned into me, 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 me,
me, me, me, me, me, me, me, me, me, me, me, me, me, that's Wallo.
He found it. He found the remedy.
267, a.k.a. Conan, king of the nut ass niggas. And over there, we have the nasty one. Nasty. Nasty boy. Don't mean a thing. Dev's a nasty boy. Nasty. Ooh, that's the old school joint. You ain't never want the college, and you know that joint. That's the college joint. Hold on. How you know the college joint? And you ain't never went to college.
He went to college for 20 years.
Now, you know what's crazy? You know what I find interesting? Gil, you came alive with two mics. You like them two mics, huh? Now it's one of one. You like it too.
I just mics. Need two mics.
You look real spiky. I just want two mics. I'll take three mics. You got real spicy with two mics. You was happy. Ah. Which one did I want? I said, whoa, that's a little too much for me. But right now, this $1 million worth of game is brought to you by Springfield Hyundai. Listen, one thing about Springfield Hyundai, they don't approve credit. They approve people. They make things happen. And you go there, you say, listen, man, Wallo sent me, man, where backdoor Bobby at? Not saying that you're trying to, but that's another story. I don't know what Bobby got going on because a lot of people been giving me some different reports about Bobby in the backdoor situation, but that's another situation. But you go there. You walk in. You got $1,000. You got whatever you got. Reasonable couple of dollars. Your credit is, I'm talking about your credit is under the earth. Your credit is with the dead people. They will bring your credit alive. They will resuscitate your credit.
Your credit is walking dead.
Yeah, walking dead. If your credit is the walking dead, they'll bring it back to life. They hit it. Wham! You be back. Hey, how you doing? My name Bobby. Shit like stuff like that. So you got to go there, check them out, man. Springfield Hyundai. Listen, they hook you up. Just go there. Tell them I sent you. Tell them this nut sent you. You know what I mean? And they listen. They're going to take care of you, but you could call them. First, 844-9-DROP-NOW, but you check them out on some website. Springfield Hyundai. Listen, SpringfieldHyundai.com, which is in Pennsylvania. Springfield, Pennsylvania. But check them out. And this $1 million worth of game is brought to you by Springfield Hyundai.
And Backdoor Bobby.
Bobby Backdoor.
Bobby's Backdoor.
No.
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 Let's get into $1 million worth of game, right? If you was messing with your woman, right, for a year, say y'all didn't live together, she had her own place, mm-hmm. And you searched her closet one day and you found a dildo was 3 times bigger
Rusty.
Than your dick.
I can bring this one back to you. What's up,
love? Hey, Rusty, listen, man. Me and Gil ran into this chick, right? There's no BS. We ran into this chick, man, and she said, you hear me, Rusty?
I can hear you.
She said, damn, what's up with your man, Rusty? We like, damn, what's up? I mean, you remember that people you was hollering at from down D.C. somewhere? She was from D.C.?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she said, damn. I said, damn, what's up with Rusty? She told me something. She told me, what's up with your man? I said, what you mean? She said, yo, you was fucking her with a dick sleeve. You was wearing dick sleeves out here, man.
Get the fuck out of here.
No, listen. On anything I love, she said that you was fucking with a dick sleeves, man.
She nicknamed you Dick Sleeve Steve.
Yeah, she said you was fucking with a dick sleeve. She said, listen, yeah, like a dildo or a dick sleeve. I said, what's that? And she texted to her. She was like, what's going on? I said, what are you talking about?
Now long sleeve Steve out here, Jesus.
Oh, so you was. But you wearing a dick sleeve.
I don't even know what a dick sleeve is, bro.
Yo, but why you just say, listen, why would she say that to us, though?
that bitch lied about a lot of stuff.
Well, listen.
I gave her a long date. That's what she meant.
No, she said, Rusty, she said you was coming up short.
She said your piece was because she said you was all balls and no stem, Rusty.
She called you, she's talking about Shorty. I said, who's Shorty? Your guy, Rusty, the guy, Shorty. I said, Shorty. But listen, hey, Russ.
Yeah.
Listen, man, your name fucked up. You got to get with her and straighten your name out.
Yeah,
man.
She put smut on your name, man. She called you Dick Sleeve Steve out here.
What'd you say?
Y'all said that on $1 million worth of game.
No, we never said that about you, man.
You said it on Angela Lee.
I ain't never said nothing about no Dick Sleeve, bro. We was talking about she was talking about dildos. See, now you trying to put that on. That's you. You the boy that rocked them goddamn sleeves, man. You out here rocking sleeves. It's cold as shit. It's going to be a cold winter. Y'all niggas better bundle up. You bundled your little shorty up, your little chubby, huh? That's what you did. But listen, man, we got to get with you later, man. What did you call him?
Dick Sleeve Steve.
Dick Sleeve Steve, right.
He made sure to slide that in.
So you messing with your woman for 2 years. Y'all, a year. Y'all don't live together. You in love with her, though. Everything seems good. You search her closet. Just being newsy. You go through her closet one day. You don't live with her, though, but you over there. And you find a dildo in there that's 3 times bigger than your dick. How do you feel? And then you see where she used it, and you see a little juices down towards the end, so you know she put the whole motherfucker in that joint.
So you realize that your chick vagina is a block party.
I mean, I'm just saying, how would you feel? Fuck how the vagina is. I'm going to keep it all. I would be hurt. I would be crushed.
Because you chubby? You got a little bit coming up short?
No, because I don't give a fuck. Let me tell you something. I don't give a fuck if your dick was this big. Right here.
You hurt because she got a big
dick. If you went to the closet and you found a dildo that was this big. Like,
I'm not enough. But listen, I thought I was giving you everything.
I'm not enough for you.
How would you feel?
I would feel like a cab driver.
What?
Cab driver.
Yeah.
What you mean?
My nigga, do you know how fucked up cab drivers feel right now that Uber and Lyft is on?
Screw your mic up.
So you feel like
not a dude. Wait, your mic loose.
Yo, what? Yo,
your mic loose.
Flag on the plate. No, wait a minute, your penalty. Like, hey, no, I'm just saying, I would feel like a cab driver, man. Like, you know how fucked up yellow cab drivers feel right now that
Uber and Lyft
is out.
You feel like somebody putting you out of business?
You feel like, no, you feel like, yeah. You just how you feel about that big ass dildo you pulled out the closet.
It was like, and this shit could vibrate?
Oh my God. How you know that, Nev?
You don't know what a vibrator is now? No, you've been in jail.
I'm just saying, we add that apartment.
Come on, man.
Apartment to this shit.
Nah, come on, man.
You level.
You seem to know about dick sleeves that nobody ever heard of before.
The chick said something about it.
You seem to know about this shit.
The chick said something about it. I didn't know, Dev.
Because we know you was in the sex business. We know you know how to build vaginas from rubber gloves like fucking MacGyver. You the nigga that really know about this.
You definitely do. You know.
Come on,
You know about all the freak technology.
Yes, you do.
You definitely do, but how would you feel if you went in April's closet and she pulled out a humongous joint? I mean, it was a humongous joint that you pulled it out.
And you know hers got the Louis Vuitton print or something on it.
She got the designer dick.
Like, you paid all that money. I'm going to be more pissed. How much you pay for this shit? You got this and you paid all that money for. Take that shit back. Clean that shit up and take it back.
She had a designer dick in the closet. That's going to be the Balenciaga dick.
I'd be mad as shit, like, damn. You gonna go get this? You saying my dick wasn't expensive enough?
No, she ain't saying that. She's saying it wasn't big enough.
Oh, that'd be crazy.
How would you feel?
I wouldn't really feel no type of way because I'm a little, you know what I mean? Oh, that's what you went to? I want to sit down. Do it right now in front of me. I wouldn't.
And then she do it. And then you sitting there thinking, that motherfucker's 3 times the size of my dick. So that means
when she was screaming, I be thinking I be putting it. But she was screaming. She
Academy
was
Award.
I'm going to keep it all the way real. All niggas love to think they tore that pussy
up.
I tore that pussy up.
Yeah, say my name.
What's my name?
Your name, Kevin. That's my name, Mike. Oh, no. I was thinking about a movie I was watching. No. Who the fuck?
Because I'm going to keep it all the way real. Two called me Idris one day.
Yo, stop.
You told me about that. Idris Elba.
She did. She called me Idris one day.
She didn't, man.
So that means she was thinking about him while you was slaying his
whatever brain. You got to do to get your thing off.
Yep.
Let me keep it all the way real. So when you getting hit or something, what you be thinking about?
My girl.
My girl getting hit.
My girl, nigga.
Nobody thinks about their girl.
Yo, stop. Gil.
Your tongue got wetter this week.
Nobody thinks about their girl. Like,
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, you're wildin'.
All right. Because I want to. And your girl ain't thinking about you. Know that. When you eating the ass from the back like a snack.
Thinking about Denzel.
She ain't thinking about you. She thinking when she was scrolling down earlier, that nigga was all on the gram like this with the husky glued up beard and the wave spinning with no shirt on.
Oh my God. She thinking it's him.
Yo.
You think she thinking about you, nigga? All right, let me ask y'all a question. If your woman had a scent, y'all got to pick one of these. If your woman had a scent, and you had to pick one of these, what would you want the scent to be?
A smell?
A smell. She had a permanent scent.
This is one perfume that I like.
No, hold on. What would you want the scent to be? Would you want it to be, let's see, a soft shell taco?
What? What
did you do? No.
A cheesesteak? Or give me one more.
A seafood platter.
Seafood platter.
Oh, she had to have one. What type of, listen, you got chicken cheesesteak too? Is it, what type of cheesesteak?
What fucking difference do it make?
What about a vegan steak? You got a veggie burger in there?
Them Jones probably stink too.
If you want. But your woman had to have one scent.
I'm going with a cheesesteak.
Damn, that's deep.
I eat cheesesteaks
a lot. I like
the
seafood platters. Because you got the scallops, your shrimps. Scallops, shrimps.
But it's not going to taste like, it's just going to smell like one, my nigga.
Oh, what type of seafood file? It ain't no wet fish like, because you know that wet fish is like a little different, got a little different. Now, fried fish from the stinger, that might not be bad.
Like, some fried shrimp.
But you mean she smell like this all the time?
All the time. Your woman got a permanent scent. Even she smell like a seafood platter, she smell like a cheesesteak.
Cheesesteak. I could pretend like she work in the deli or something, and that's why she just smell like that.
Or she smell like a soft shell taco.
No, but see, the cheesesteak is a lot of onions involved, man. You got to think about that. You got them onions and peppers chopping on that joint. So that onion, that thing kick in. You might catch them like, woo, ho, baby, you got no arms. Like, what's going on?
At least they not raw onions. They like fried onion.
Yeah, that do bring the smell down.
It do.
I think I might go with the soft shell taco. That don't really have that much smell.
You crazy as hell.
I might go with toot, smell like a soft shell.
Yeah.
Soft shell toot.
I like the seafood platter though, because you can smell like, I think that'd be, yo, hold the fuck up. We really talk, what the fuck? Like all the time, she got to smell like the seafood.
All the time.
Yeah, well, I'm at
toot going to be a soft shell taco.
Was you high when you came up with this?
Yeah, what type of shit?
No, because, you know, everybody got a certain scent to them. Everybody got their own scent.
Yo, what do I smell like?
You smell like oodles and noodles.
That ain't bad. Now, that's a compliment for me.
No, but the reason is because he taking the actual powder and dabbing it on his neck. This nigga, like, that, you know, in jail, they got to make up colognes and shit. They got to come up with shit. I hit the visiting room. You know what I mean? I went to the packets. You know what I mean?
I hit the packet a little bit.
You know what's crazy?
Little shrimp seasoning.
No, this was crazy, though. When we used to be in jail, and then they start ripping them out. You know how they used to send the samples where you unpeel it in the magazines and it had a little smell?
Mm-hmm.
We dudes used to take them. My one homie, right? He used to have a chip bag filled of them joints. Because, you know, dudes use chip bags to clean it out. You go to his joint, yeah, man, I need one of them scents. Oh, yeah, what you need, baby? He pulled the joints out like he really was selling like he had a perfume store. Yeah. What joint you need? Go ahead, check that joint out. That joint right there, that's the joint when my man, you remember, what's his name, plugged me up with the joint? I wore that joint that day. She's still rocking with me. I'm like...
That nigga was like Nordstrom.
That's paper. No, because what you do is you take it and you just like he'll rip a piece off of it, take it and you just wipe it on you. It's the paper that from the advertisement in the magazines you had in cologne. And you just wipe it on, you go out there, hey baby, what's up? Oh, you smell it? You like that? What's that? Oh yeah, that's jupe. How the fuck you get that in there? Like, I make moves, baby. I'm out here making moves.
No, that's kind of smart.
Yeah, that was smart. It was a nice flavor. But I didn't understand why dudes was wearing it like to the chow hall and shit like that. Like,
yeah, dog, see, that's
not
different.
Going on a visit, but like what you trying to catch? Like, niggas be trying to catch in the joint. I'm just saying, I don't know.
What about for a lady guard or something like that?
No. That ain't got nothing to do with inmates. I'm telling if they,
you know what I mean? They try to do this so that when the lady guard grip them up, they smell like how you was trying to set the guard up to see your dick and all that. Oh,
my God. Yeah, it depends. Because some of them jails, you had lady guards, they look like linebackers
What about the nurses?
Like Lawrence Taylor.
I'm talking about you. You had them. You had them.
It's like Terrell.
Listen. In the mountains, you had them big farm girls, them big white farm girls. Teeth be going. They teeth be like, oh, is that her teeth or is she chewing? They chewing tobacco, spitting you in the yard. Like, oh, god damn, big
come
Jeff.
On, man.
You're like shit. So you, and then you had dudes trying to. One thing about dudes when you were in jail, a chick could look like Lawrence Taylor in real life. But to you, for some reason, she looked like Holly Berry. Oh, man, she looked good as
did
shit.
Did that start happening to you, too?
Yeah, that like, shit started happening
just naturally,
yeah. Yeah, that shit.
That's like, so you was up there, you was looking at ugly bitches, and they was looking good?
Yeah. I was in jail.
Yeah. Oh, okay, cool. What's the matter with you? So did any men start looking like women to you?
No.
No. You're using the excuse. I was in jail.
I was in jail. Boy looked like he had a fatty, dude.
Jamal's ass was kind of fat, that jumper. I was in jail. I was in jail.
Fuck out of here.
Ass fat in the jumper.
Hey, nigga turned into Rocky. I was in jail. I was in jail. Give me your pass, cuz. Oh, I was in jail.
No.
Jamal ass look fat in that jumper. I was in jail. What can I say? That's excuse.
Jumper
that's
Jamal.
That's his excuse. I went to jump in Jamal's jumper. I was in jail. Where you want, Rock?
I'm going to say something, though. I'm going to tell you. This story from the cell is going to be interesting.
You jumped in Jamal's jumper.
It was deep. It was deep. He going to grind me up. You going to grind me up from that shit, Dev.
Yeah, he was. How we talk about it. Jamal got a jumper. He got a fat ass in his jumper. And you talking about, I got a story from the set.
I got a story about that.
Just reminded me.
It's some deep
jousting
shit.
In jail with Jamal's jumper.
It's some deep shit.
What, you gonna finally tell us the nigga that ripped your jumper off?
My name is
Stop.
The streets.
Let me ask y'all a question. If you fucking a woman raw, right? Should you know her parents?
Come on.
Nobody know nobody parents.
Yeah, something's come
dudes
on.
Dudes be rolling the dice all the time, don't know nobody parents.
Should you know?
The baby will jump off before you know a parents.
Should you know a social security number?
I mean, you're definitely not going to know that.
I think you should know that.
You ain't going to. How you going to know somebody's fucking social security?
You know
security?
You ain't got April fucking social.
You out your fucking mind.
No, what you don't.
I'm going to just tell you a social security number out here in public. Yeah, I got
give
a
us the last four digits.
No.
Nigga, this like AT&T, nigga. Give us the last four of your social. Yo.
Oh.
That's not four digits, dickhead.
Listen, oh.
He gonna try to short me. He's a dickhead.
Come on.
Because I'm gonna keep it all way real. So.
What about her real name?
What about a real name?
Do you know a real name?
I mean, you supposed to.
No, I'm saying, how many times you threw your you
come
threw
on,
your piece,
man. Listen,
you threw your piece no, of crap
listen,
table
listen. First off,
and didn't know none of this.
First off,
because she might burn you and give you the package.
Yeah, and then you just out there in the world hunting
she
for.
Disappear.
You,
I'm gonna keep it all way real. By the time two got this dick raw, I had already knew a social.
No.
You're a liar.
No. Before
you're
two,
a liar.
Listen, before two, when you were just running around here throwing your piece on the table, or when you was a rapper.
Don't lie.
Okay, I knew.
No. We talking about the chicks in the hotels and different.
He's lying.
I never been no nigga that just take a bitch to a hotel and give a raw dick, man. I ain't never threw my dick on the table like that.
You mean to tell me in your life you never hit that raw?
Hold on, you
knew all this information.
Hold on.
I always do that. Yeah,
that's your story you sticking to.
Hey, listen.
Well, what about this?
He on his Bill Clinton.
This white line.
Let me
what about
you
the time we was in Nanny basement? We had Sassy Cassie down there.
I ain't hit that
you
raw.
You talking about his whole
he hit Sassy Cassie raw?
I hit that raw. You know I hit that raw.
She was a prostitute, too.
You know I ain't fuck her raw, nigga.
This was the classic about him.
And I went first.
You know where the joint was?
I always went first. I'm the oldest.
So he went first and raw. So
you know what's his joint?
His thing was.
His joint was the condom pop. Joint pop. I'm in there. I'm already in school.
He had it pre-ripped.
He had it pre-ripped. He threw a little slice in all his condoms. He just take a razor to the joint. It popped.
If he dies, he dies.
I don't need to come out now. Like,
first of all.
Hey, yo.
He just leave the condom in the pussy and keep fucking. Ah, it came off. Ooh, it was too big. I had a 3X hoodie on. only wear medium. I had a 3X hoodie on. He got to spread the bitch legs open, dig all in the pussy. His back there something.
He figured if the condom back there, maybe it'll just catch it. Like
he like this.
Like a wall. Like oh, a man. Like
he
a
got,
defender.
He got this much in the bitch. We almost got it. There we go.
That's selfish.
Man, you ain't no toot social security number for you. Crazy as shit. Man.
Hold on.
Hold on. Let's do some math. Let's do some math real quick. How old is your oldest kid with toot?
20.
And you've been with her only like 20 years, right?
Fuck no. Been with her forever.
You wasn't around here throwing your piece. I ain't gonna say nobody names, but you wasn't throwing your piece on the.
Shannon Williams.
No, I ain't talking about you. I ain't talking about the mothers of your children. I'm talking about all them.
Tyra Fierce.
I'm talking about all them party girls.
Tyra Fierce.
Yeah, of course you know them. Shannon Williams. Birth certificate.
No.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, court cases.
Okay, first of all.
He trying to get around and just talking about the mother of his children.
Yeah, like he just
what
shoot.
What about all that partying
like,
you
like
had?
Every time he went wrong, he just shot for 100%.
First of all, you know how many bitches me and Spade partied together, man? Because when we went on tour.
Why are you incriminating somebody? No, you snitching. That was a snitch back.
Listen, you snitching on your face, telling on you.
He don't want his public business out there.
We was on tour. This was years ago. This was 20 plus years ago. We on tour. Do you know how many bitches me and Spade party together, man? We ain't never, ever been the type of niggas that's going to fuck some bitches raw, man.
Well, why every time I party something with you, the condom pop? Pop, I'm in there. I'm not even going to stay there.
Yeah, yours pop.
No, yours
pop. I'm like, cuz, you shouldn't have did that, man. You're tripping, cuz. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I'm going to pull out, cuz. I'm shooting blanks. I can't handle kids anyway. Don't worry about it. First of all, let me just tell you something. Motherfuckers, I tell you, man, anybody that ever party some yabba dabbas with me, and it's a lot of niggas out here that done party some yabba dabbas with me. I ain't never been no type of nigga. First of all, I cuss Dutch the fuck out because he was striking bitches on the motherfucking tour of Raw.
Yo, why you telling me?
He was striking bitches raw. We was in like 11 cities in it. And then what happened was he grinded bump up.
We was 11 cities in.
Let me tell you something. It was a few bitches every city. Trust me. It wasn't just one bitch. We had them bitches lined up outside the hotel room like goddamn the welfare line. You hear me? And he grinded bump up on the tour bus. Him and Bump shared the room. He grinded bump up on the tour bus. Bump was so mad he just bust out and said, "Nigga, that's why you fucking all them bitches raw. You ain't had no condoms yet." Everybody, it was like, niggas was like, wait, hold on.
Had no condoms yet.
He like, nigga, we done went through Pittsburgh, Cincinnati, Cleveland, Dayton, Detroit, Milwaukee, motherfucking Cincinnati, motherfucking.
She had Cincinnati. Yeah.
Oh, all right. Well, you know, and you ain't.
Come on, man.
You ain't. Put a helmet on your soldier, yeah, player.
So you saying Wallo's allegations of the health department calling on you was false? He was making false allegations.
Yeah, they did call. They put his name. They had him on some billboards. On,
they man. Was putting smut on your
he
name.
Got burned, that, he got burned. He was lighting shit on
He was
fire.
Bernie Sanders or nah?
Yep, yes, he was Bernie Sanders. He was burning shit. He wasn't running with him. He was running. He was Bernie. See, Bernie running for something. He was running from something.
Bernie made all.
First of all, you was the original Hottie Pippin. Fuck is you talking about?
Why you think he was on Cash Money?
The hot boys.
By the time I came around Cash Money, they wasn't the hot boys no more. That era had passed, nigga.
No, you was a hot boy.
Fuck is wrong
Hottie with Pippen you. Is hilarious.
Yeah, he was Hottie Pippen. Yeah, I mean, back then, I remember when Tino had to take you get the shot in the ass, yeah, to clean you up.
He said he went right back in Raw afterwards with the same joint at birthday.
Absolutely. You already told on yourself.
No, but that
you
was
get, your bitch get your hot sausage. My son just had a hot sausage.
Come on, man. Why you keep telling me?
Don't put that out there.
He did. He just had it. Listen, let me tell you something.
Come on, man.
Every nigga in this room done had a hot sausage before.
Nah.
Rock, look at B-Rock. B-Rock definitely.
He always never looked at the camera.
B-Rock minded his business.
B-Rock told him, look at the
camera.
I'm looking at the camera. I got to edit.
B-Rock did start staring
then,
off yonder.
Nasty Dev. Oh, he had everything.
Dev stayed fired.
Nah, man.
But Dev had everything.
Listen. How many pieces you think you hit wrong?
Listen, man. Listen, this is I'm not Angela Yee. What's the jig name?
How many bitches you hit wrong in your life?
You're not throwing me under this bus.
How many fires conquered you in your life?
I plead the fifth, and I never been burnt. I'm like motherfucking what's her name, Khaleesi and shit.
I ain't never been burnt, man.
That's real shit.
You was a fireman out here.
Listen, man.
fucking Lil Wayne.
Fireman.
Fireman. Fireman.
Yo, that's a classic.
Yo,
stop.
That shit was hot. Hey, for the record, you know he recorded that in Philadelphia, right?
Yep. Did Rug mix that down?
No, Rug recorded it, mixed it down, everything.
All right.
I'm just saying, he recorded that song in Philadelphia.
That's a legend. There's something more to that.
I'm still trying to run in the baby so I get my picture with him.
Come on, man. You said a professional cock host.
Yeah, it's cool. Whatever you want to say.
That's going to be a legendary picture.
He
going to walk right up. Hey, baby, you know Gillie, my cousin. Oh, yeah, fucking baby.
I told him to put me on. He used to be on some dumb shit. I said, where baby? I used to call him from jail. Yo, we put baby on the phone.
Don't get
what the fuck you calling me for baby shit. For? That's number one stunner. I got to holler at him. Like, I'm a fan of music. I'm a fan of his music.
Stunner to kiss him in his mouth like
come
Wayne.
On.
No, the fuck you went.
Yes, he would.
I'll be Stunner the fuck up.
Stunner, kiss you the fuck right in your mouth.
That's my homie, but he ain't going to be kissing me.
Stunner kiss you right now. Come say, Wolf. Come here, Wolf.
The fuck he not?
Come here, Wolf.
Come on, man. He kissed him. Kiss him and piss his ass. Stunner kiss him. You want to sign?
Yo, he said kiss him in his ass. Come on.
He said, "Oh, don't tell nobody, baby.
Come on, girl, nah, come on,
said, baby,
man.
You gonna kiss Stunner for Instagram pic, nigga? Get
the fuck out of here.
He gonna be like this. You know how niggas take pictures of me front. He gonna kiss him and say, Stunner told me I'm the new little weed.
Listen, man, that's my boy, Stunner, man.
Come on, man.
Stunner told me I'm the new Wayne. To pick like this.
Come on, man.
I can't wait to run in the stunner. Yo, I'm like, listen, why you should sign me? My son Kelly's was a fucking nut.
He gonna go right that way, Wayne, man, because I'm his son now.
Come on, man.
Number one stunner.
We just fucking around. Let me ask you a question. Who would you be? If you could be the best basketball player, the best rapper.
Name the people. Who would the people be? What you
okay, if you could be LeBron James, or who would be considered the best rapper right now? Drake? Or...
Oh, Drake is not the best rapper. You mean the biggest rapper?
Hold on, what you talking
biggest
about?
The
biggest rapper.
Okay.
You talking about the... How much money is each person make? The money they...
No, they all make the same amount of money.
Oh, that's easy.
Okay. So you could be LeBron James, you could be Drake, or you could be El Chapo. Who you picking?
Nobody's gonna pick. Who the fuck gonna pick El Chapo? How the fuck you put El Chapo with
niggas
with
pick
Drake and LeBron?
You, do you know niggas how many of these goofy ass niggas got dreams of being a drug lord?
Absolutely.
Let me just tell you something. The reality of this shit is some niggas want to be a BET special.
Yeah.
This is the whole...
American gangster.
On the next American gangster.
Niggas will get some advance money and buy a brick just to say they bought one finally. Like just...
No, they not.
Yes, they do.
Nigga, you out of your fucking mind.
Okay, let me just tell you something.
I'm not... Why the fuck would you do that?
Okay, let me just say something. Rest in peace to Juice WRLD. I don't know if it's the truth or not, but they had footage of some luggage they opened up.
Yeah, I seen that.
It's, I think they said 70 something pounds of weed.
Yeah, shit, crazy.
So you got on to fly in private jets with 70 pounds worth of weed. Okay.
Crazy.
Obviously, you got some of the dumbest niggas around you possible. Because one thing's for sure, two things for certain is you always protect the money.
You never.
Now, I'm not judging.
But listen,
I'm just saying.
Never put the money in danger. All
never
you
put
dudes
the money
there,
in danger.
If you want some dumb shit, get the fuck away from your homies that's doing some successful things in life. Not just music, sports, business, whatever they're doing. Stay away from them.
Because you
dumb
never
shit.
Put the money in danger. So rest in peace to that young man.
Rest in peace to Juice WRLD.
You know, I don't know what he was going through. And I'm just mentioning this to all the
that's
future
real. I never
artists.
Thought about that, though.
To all the future artists that's getting on, you don't get on to fly around with 70 pounds worth of weed. That's all I'm saying.
Absolutely not.
You think y'all niggas gonna be taking all this shit on private jets like it's sweet and...
Pistols and all.
And the captain ain't gonna rat you the fuck out.
Yeah, he not a part of your organization.
He don't know none about that shit. Yeah. He don't give a fuck about none of that. He's like, it's marijuana and guns on his
Do you think that's making it hot for other rappers that's not even on that time?
Right.
Like on the private jet game?
Of course.
People got to stop blaming that pilot, too. He got a job. That's something different.
Just like when the hip-hop police first formed. that shit made it hot for everybody. Like, for everybody. Yo, the hip hop police on y'all. Oh,
what was the reason for them forming?
Because I guess, you know, because all the rappers is running around with the burners.
Yeah, and
they all
and,
got the guns. It was like he rapped. Okay, he got a gun. Come yeah, on,
you got young. You got young black people making money, and then some of the record labels is started by crime organizations. They trying to get the big fish. You know what I'm saying?
Then at the end of the day, let's be for real. At the end of the day, the record label put the hip hop police out there.
That shit just made shit look more official.
No, niggas ain't selling.
Mm-hmm.
Go book the nigga with the burner.
Mm-hmm.
Write him off.
Get some press in the morning. Yep, no, get some press in the morning. Nigga sell some records. Coming up out of SOB, such and such had a...
Do you think they really done that?
Yes.
Man, absolutely.
Let me tell you something. You could go to a record company and say, oh, I want to do a song about killing some animals. They'd be like, ah, nigga, no.
Yep.
Wait, hold on. White people give a fuck about that. What do you mean?
I want to do a song about... empowering black people.
Empowering niggas? No, we don't want niggas to be empowered. What are you talking about? I got little Raheem. He got this hot ass record about how he shot the block up and he killed niggas. It's a market for that.
Take this $1 million advance.
It's definitely a market for that. He's going to talk about how he's going to wipe the whole race out in his record. And it's a fucking market for that. It's not a market for killing deers. Mm-mm.
Yeah.
White people give a fuck about that. We don't give a fuck about you niggas killing each other. It's a big market for that.
Cut the check. Stay right there. Let me get our accounting department to bring the check down right now. $1 million.
How many niggas did you kill on this album? Count them up. Okay.
Give him $1 million for each nigga.
Kill 742 niggas on this album?
$742 million. Give him a deal. The biggest deal in history.
So at the end of the day, that's how this shit work, man. That's just...
Nah. That's a fact.
Record labels don't give a fuck about niggas. They give a fuck about money. They throw the hip-hop police right on your goofy ass. They come up. That's part of their marketing scheme. Wait, this nigga ain't. He's coming out in 3 weeks. We don't have any traction.
How many guns? And then they got one assistant. You know they keep an assistant. Somebody from the label that's running around with the artist. How many guns you have on?
Mm-hmm.
Make sure he had the guns in the car when you call the police.
Mm-hmm. Him and his main man, JoJo.
They got the AK right now.
They got AK. Call the police right now.
Draco.
Say you got to wait. Say you're waiting for, what's his name? Keep him there at the bus.
Because his single Draco is going to do numbers after he get caught with the Draco.
Keep him there at the highway stop right now. Say go back in there and get a Big Mac. Hold up. I got to give me another Big Mac.
And the fans be like, he was really bouty. He had the Draco.
Listen, they always come run up on a bus and they know where the tour bus at. They know where all the guns at. Do you think Lil Wayne went all the way up when he got caught with that whole thing happened?
Oh, yeah, he went to jail.
And it went crazy.
Yo, hold on. So I'm picking Drake because we got off.
Who you picking?
But it just fucked me up that people would pick the drug dealer. But then I thought about it because, like I said, the athlete, the executive, the regular businessman, everybody want to be the rapper. And then it's like the rapper always wanted to be the street nigga. So when they finally get their money, they emulate the lives of the street nigga. But the thing is, they're on a whole nother level financially. I mean, but they still be emulating that because growing up sometimes you see that. Like every neighborhood, every ghetto, you see, you grow up and you like, you know, you see that dude got all the money. No, now you're emulating him because you always wanted to be him.
You actually see those three things with money. Drug dealers, niggas that end up playing basketball, and niggas that end up rapping.
So
and
who would you be?
I'm picking Drake.
Why?
Because I'd rather make music and... I'm going to tell you why. Because he said they're making the same amount of money now, right? So they make the same amount of money. Basketball player, let's say, how long is a basketball player's career?
Right, that's deep.
How long is their career? I don't know.
LeBron 13. James, 15, 20, depends on... You're LeBron James, you can play for 20 years.
20 years, something like that. So when you're done playing basketball, you know how like kids don't grow up and they don't know nothing about Jordan except his sneaker. But like songs... will play forever, never, never. I'd rather have the songs play forever. I got the same amount of money. I like being creative. That's what I would pick. I ain't no athlete. You feel me? So I'm wrong with that.
But no. Only reason you said it, like, they know about Michael, but Michael Jordan is bigger than Drake.
Right.
No. This is what I'm saying. Like, Michael Jordan, basketball, these kids never saw his game, nothing. They know his sneaker. That's the main thing they know.
At the end of the day, you can't say that because generations change. And... 15 years from now, niggas ain't going to be listening to Drake. They going to know who he is, just like the kids of the day. They don't listen to Jay-Z. They know who he is.
For the most part, you're right.
Well, but they're not running around. You ain't got no 14-year-old kid in his car. Hove, H to the OV.
Nah, that's true. That's true for the most part.
Snowflakes by the OZ.
That's true about for the most part.
The same thing.
Well, this is what I'm saying. You asking what I would rather.
Yeah.
I know that people even my age will still be listening, right, to my music. They're not just turning on an old Michael Jordan basketball game. Like, I don't know if niggas just do that. Like, yo, I was just watching old games.
They play on TV all the time.
But I never hear about niggas watching old games. So me personally, I'm running with a rapper. That's what I'm running. All right.
Me, I'd be LeBron James. I had to be him.
You can't be LeBron, though, dog.
Why?
Because you're garbage.
Come on, man.
Like, your fucking game is horrible.
So he's
like,
so trash, he can't even pick it. Who would you be?
You got to be El Chapo. You did 20 years. He locked up. You was locked up. You got to be El Chapo.
He didn't escape. He didn't escape from jail.
No, I didn't escape another. I stayed there and done my time.
You did, but still.
He couldn't call no shots or nothing.
Okay, hold on. Wait. He was a D-list rapper.
He ain't no matter what his rap.
He was a D-list rapper, so he could be Drake, right? He basketball skill. Oh my goodness.
I heard you ain't that much better than him in basketball.
Nigga, please. He connects the most with L. You connect the most with LL.
LL Chapo.
LL Chapo.
So you and Jill singing, I need love. That's crazy.
No, he's in jail singing, I need drugs. Damn, damn. Damn, damn. Sometimes I sit when I'm alone in my room, sometimes I sit at the wall.
And in the back
and
of
my
mind,
I need my plug.
Eight ball call.
No,
of my mind, I need my plug to call.
Yeah, you hear
drugs.
My connect call.
Boom, boom, boom.
I need drugs. Yeah, that's crazy.
See, this the sad part. Somebody's gonna watch this show and they gonna make this one of these motherfucking kids, nigga, with their auto tune all the way up.
I need drugs.
I need drugs.
That's crazy, man.
Yo, I wouldn't be surprised if somebody already made that.
Sometimes I stare at the wall and I just look at my phone waiting for the plug to call. I need drugs.
Somebody had to make that.
That's crazy.
Boom, boom. Hey, so I'm being LeBron. Just because basketball is my first love before Tootie, before my kids, before anything. Basketball was my first love.
He went to a Z-list college. Fuck is he talking about?
Yo, yeah.
He talking, now you want to hate on my game. His college was Z-list.
He went to one of them joints they show on TV with Lil Romeo and shit, where he said you could get an education.
He went to Everest. The joint I be doing the commercials for. Hey, you want to go to college? Why you don't want to go to college?
You should get off your ass right now.
This is the type of college that give you a scholarship. All you need is $1.
Hold on.
You
can play. So he was playing ball for an online college?
He played ball for online college. Nobody was at the game but him.
Nigga was playing 2K.
And then he beat his stack. Because one thing about the online college, what they do is they remix college names. It'd be like, listen, it'd be Penn State. It'd be Penn University State. So you're thinking, that's a big college. That's a big ass college. You know, they're Penn University State. Ain't a such thing. He told me, yeah, I want to play for Penn University State. So niggas like, damn, he played for Penn State. He's a beast, that boy. Yeah, Gil was a no. You went to nobody. Listen, the college you went to, it was one. Listen, it was one suite in a. The college was a suite in a PO box at a post office. It was a PO box number. It was a suite. So how the fuck? Nobody came. Nobody even knew about the shit. It was just a PO box number. The college he played for. Tell me, yeah, I played college ball. He always told me, yeah, I played college. Nobody never seen you play.
That's cool. Ain't listen, man. Ain't nobody trying to hear that, man.
The Z League.
Ain't nobody trying to hear that shit. Oh, man. Listen, first of all, they wouldn't even let you play in the yard, nigga.
Man, it was crazy. I was a legend.
They wouldn't let him play in the yard. Or
no, I ain't going to front. I seen somebody get socked one day. That's when I retired. Nigga went up for alley hoop. I said, okay, I'm filing my papers. I'm getting my retirement benefits.
He said, I want to cook now.
I'm changing the sport. You can change sports? Because he went from basketball to boxing. I'm going from basketball to cooking. I'm out of here. Fuck that. Nigga did a nice clean layup across the board. I said, oh, yeah, this ain't my Jordan. I mean... Shit, crazy.
This kid took me like crazy.
Nigga said, I ain't playing.
Nigga socked you ran to the kid. Nigga socked the nigga, you ran to the kitchen, huh? Hey, said, I need some game, OG. My children's father seems to think when I ask him to buy things for his children and he takes too long, that if I buy it, he no longer has the obligation to give me the money. He thinks because they have it already, he's in the clear. What the fuck is up with this new generation? This happens way more frequently than not, so I'm a little pissed. What you think, OG?
But I think is he's never going to buy none because you always going to buy it. Fuck you. It ain't like he. That's the type. That's his mindset. You can't. One thing about it. No kind. Nothing that he's going to say. Nothing going. It ain't got nothing to do with dude. It ain't got nothing to do with Gil. Got something to do with you. The shit that you keep going for.
Right.
He. That's not who he is. Okay. Like a lot of these women, they get with dudes and be like, oh damn, you're not changing nobody. People is in their way because it's always another chick that's going to accept whatever he got going on. There's too many women out here, dude. Right. So she like, he like, man, what's she going? She going to keep buying it. What the fuck I got to worry about? So you keep buying it, so it don't even matter.
I think she, right, accountability.
Yeah.
She don't make the nigga be accountable. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's one of a major key, man. Making your partner be accountable. You feel what I'm saying? So, and I can't reiterate on this enough. Women, you gotta be accountable for yourself for picking bad niggas. Like, okay, let's get into another question. How many niggas, bad niggas, is a woman allowed to pick before she's considered
the problem, right?
Right. Like how many goofballs do you give a woman to pick? How many bum ass niggas do you give a woman?
Like,
to pick?
You like, talking about that they have kids with? If I see two, yeah. I'm like, yo, you, yeah, that's it.
Like, how many niggas? Like, because you got some women out here. They done
about 15.
They some damn
15.
That's how they go about through 15.
No, I'm talking about nah, bro.
No. I'm talking about from our standpoint. How many niggas?
Damn, that's why y'all said 15.
I'm like,
how many from our standpoint? How many niggas? How many goofy niggas do she got to deal with for you to look at her and be like, bitch, they're not just the goofballs. You're the goofball, too. Like, you the GB2. That's a movie, GB2.
Yeah, I mean, GB2. Not CB4, GB2. No. Right. But no, you know what? You know what's crazy about that? Like, the reality is they go through so many. See, it's different for men. Like, if we were single, we'd go out there and holler at a bunch of different, 10 different women, and they're going to be able to form to whatever we got going on. It's more easier for men than it is for women because you got so many dudes out here that's just dead smack, people that's dead smacking away that ain't trying to do nothing. Like I said before, like, you got a bunch of scared street niggas out here. Like, what I'm saying is, how you a street nigga, you're not paying no bills. You're not buying the kids no sneakers. You're just, you're a part of the street game, and I'm not condoning the street game, but you're already in it. And you're saying you're not getting out of it. You're a real nigga. What I'm saying or what anybody got to say to you, you're not trying to hear. But you're a street nigga. But where I'm from and where I grew up, street niggas pay bills. They pay tuitions. They bought houses. They bought cars. They started businesses. The street niggas I know, the dudes right. I look up to that was OGs and around us.
Right.
But number one, they paid fucking bills. Like they wasn't posting up in a chick crib like it's a prison cell and it's free, getting three hots in a cot.
Right.
So my whole thing is like, you got all these scared street niggas out here. Like, you're in the streets and you're not making no money. Dad.
Some of these niggas ain't even good at being street niggas. That's what it is. You're not even good at that, nigga. You don't make no money. You don't know how to make no fucking money.
And you just in the streets posting up. Waiting to catch a case or waiting to kill somebody, waiting to catch a case, waiting to fuck somebody's life up, waiting to fuck somebody's property value up or their neighborhood. Mm-hmm. And you're just a street nigga though, because you want to be classified as a street nigga and you think being anything outside of a street nigga, you're a nut. No, you are a fucking nut because you're not making no money and right. You're not doing nothing. You're just posting up.
And on the flip side, so, there's niggas that pick multiple bum ass baby moms too. You be like, yo, what's up?
Hold on, let's get to that. Let's get to that. But one second, but hold on. So you saying that if you were street nigga, and you ain't making no money, you a nut ass nigga.
Yeah, why you in the streets? What is you out there for? Like, you think about it. You got people that's just out there, no bullshit. They decorating the scenery. They decorating the hood. They making it look like a hood. And it's like, yo, dog, like, y'all 10 niggas need don't even need it. If y'all stop posting up on this corner, the property value might be, but y'all fucking the whole neighborhood up, and y'all just literally out here, dudes literally be posting up out there waiting to go to jail, waiting for somebody to come and kill them.
Sitting ducks.
Because it don't make no sense, because, like, the street game was for dudes to make a legal hustle, wherever you was hustling. Right? And let me get some of that. Selling drugs and hustling is two different things. Being a hustler and a drug dealer is two different things. Mm. Drugs sell itself. Hustlers hustle shit to you. Hustlers sell shit to you that you wasn't looking to buy. That's what a hustler do. A hustler go and find things and say, I'm gonna make people buy this shit. A drug dealer is somebody to say, let me tell you something. If you look from the 80s to now, a drug, whether it was crack, whether it was weed, whether it was heroin, whatever it was, Def, you think about this, Def. When the heroin was selling, when old head Mike in the 80s was selling it, and it's selling now, that little Dave is selling it. But it's the heroin is selling it. They're not selling it because there are people coming to you. And we living in a world where though people shit off the phones and people call you. I mean, even in back in the day, you had to, like, it'd be like 15 niggas on one block on Germantown and Allegheny, and a car pulled up, they jumping over the car. It was crazier then. But even now, but like, drug going to sell itself. You could put drug in the door and just have a robot there. People going to come buy drugs. But no, like, for me to make you buy a shirt with my movement on it, that's hustling.
Mm-hmm.
That's being able to hustle. And I'm not talking about hustling people where as though you're trying to get them to do, like, you're trying to spin them. Mm-hmm. No, I'm talking about being able to grind. Like, we don't, the street lack hustlers. The street lack grinders. And we living in a time where as though it's just thorough as a token of honor to people. And it's a badge of honor to say, I'm a street nigga. Mm-hmm. But you don't get no money.
Right.
So you shouldn't tell nobody you're a street nigga.
Because in life, you got two types of people. You got the strivers.
Shout out to the working niggas out there, too. Shout out to y'all.
Shout out, y'all.
You got the strivers, and you got the survivors. Some motherfuckers want to strive to be great. Some motherfuckers is not going to sit around and just, okay, cool. I work at this job. I make this much money. I just want to do this for the rest of my life. That's just, no. I want to take some of this money. Some people be content with that. Even with motherfuckers that get money to motherfuckers from the lower level. See, but then with hustling, most of the niggas that hustle is survivors. That's it. You got one nigga or two niggas that's really making some money. Then you got some niggas right under them that's AI. And then you got these niggas.
Hoagie and weed money.
These niggas at the bottom right here. These niggas right here at the bottom. These is the goofballs right here. You know why? Because they ain't going to never strive from where they at. Because they only get, you can't get them niggas too much. Get them niggas this. Let them work that off.
Hoagie and weed money.
Get back. Get them niggas this. But, and all they want to do is survive. That's their mentality. I just want to survive through the day. I want to get my weed money. If I like to pop perks, if I like to get a little drink, I got a good food. If I want to take my bitch out, I could. They just want to survive. Every day is about surviving. Then you got the nigga at the top. He's trying to strive. He the nigga that actually is a businessman. He's a hustler. He's the hustler. He get on the plane. He go out to Cali. He meet niggas.
And he hustling humans. He hustling everybody up under him.
Right.
He hustling them niggas.
Right. You feel what I'm saying? He's actually making some money. So he actually is living in the better places. He got a doorman in it at his condo. So that's the cycle of this shit. You feel what I'm saying? You very rarely do you have a motherfucker at the bottom that's like, I'ma hustle every day, I'ma stack my money, and then fuck that, I'ma go back at him, and I'ma when I go back at him, I'ma have my money right, and I'ma wanna, no, fuck that stuff. You can't give me nothing, my nigga. I got my money right. I wanna, fuck that. I want a whole thing. Whatever it is. At the bottom, they just trying to survive, man. At the bottom, they go to jail the fastest. So they make the less money.
Easiest to grab up.
And they right there in the line of fire. Right there on the block. Right there in the line of fire. Every day, just this nigga, he ain't never in the line of fire. He come through however many times he drop his shit off, haul ass away from that block. Arf! So it's always the niggas at the bottom that get it the worst. That's just the reality of it.
And that's the most people, they at the bottom.
Right.
The majority is at the bottom.
Right.
Because when you drive past the block, the dudes is there, a lot of them be at the bottom. The people that's really, you never see them.
Right. Never see them. And then if you do see him, it's just because he a dickhead. And he just want to be out there to remind all of them niggas, they at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
He get all the fame when he out there, he the man. So he feel like a rapper. Just in this small little ass neighborhood that he from, because he's the true hustler, the one who could think, because really what he doing in the streets, he could be doing in somewhere else. He just choose to do it in the streets. You feel what I'm saying? He could open up a cleaning bit. He could do whatever he want to do in life. Because if you got the intuition to be able to fly, meet some people, bust it up, get a shitload of drugs in, be good with the numbers, you could do anything right in life.
You just think is small-minded in that regard.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, it's like some motherfuckers is striving and some motherfuckers is surviving. I've always been a nigga that my mindset was to strive. I'm not trying to settle for less because I want to have a legacy when I leave planet Earth. Mm-hmm. I want to, when I pass, I want niggas to be sitting around talking about a nigga, not just talking about the bad shit that I did. Remember when the nigga jumped out and the nigga had the nigga, woo, that, no, uh-uh. Fuck all that. That nigga was giving cars away to families in need. That nigga was dropping that game on the youth. That nigga, I like that nigga music.
Wallo was putting him in headlocks.
That nigga had movies out. That nigga, you feel what I'm saying? So we got God give us all opportunity to be great. Some motherfuckers don't want to be great. Some niggas ain't got it in them to be great.
And they don't see greatness in themselves, so they hate to see it in somebody else.
So do you think that it's possible that that woman don't see greatness in herself, and that's why she keeps on picking niggas that don't have that?
Absolutely.
You don't feel good about, when you feel good about yourself, when you know your value, when you know your worth, you just ain't dealing with certain shit.
Right.
You ain't, Dev. You ain't going to deal with a certain woman. You ain't going to deal with a certain stuff. You ain't going to live in a certain, you know, your house got to be a certain way. It's a lot of shit that you're not going to deal with.
Right. See, for me, I can't deal with a woman who thinks she a nigga. That's just not my, what? Yeah, I'm sitting there, we going back and forth, you talking to me like you about to knock me the fuck out.
It was one time I heard Gina talking to him.
What'd she say to him?
She told him, oh no, and I ain't talking about the finger pop joint. The joint,
she ain't saying nothing about no finger pop.
What's she saying, Lo?
When she told him, you acting like a real bitch right now. I said, oh shit.
She
said that shit. I said, whoa. You're acting like a bitch.
He went crazy.
He lost his, what? Hey. We was walking out the door. Hey. He lost his mind.
There's a difference between a motherfucker saying you acting like a bitch and you're a real bitch right now.
It was crazy.
Wait, hold on.
He stopped at double back. Who the fuck you talking to?
You ever wanted to fight Reg where he's like, I can't beat you, I'll bring Reg over here, I'm a fight. Nah, cause that's what happened with me and my girl. I'll be like, tell your brother to come over.
he freaky boy too. Tell your brother to come over here right now. I'll wrestle him down to the ground.
You see how he had to turn
argue, but listen,
this you're not talking to nigga.
This nigga, come on.
I'll tell you this, I got your brother and your sister.
You're lucky you ain't in jail with me, nigga.
Y'all know Dev loves some jujitsu.
Y'all listen, you know
he'll wrestle a nigga down.
When they argue, all he got is his Crown Fighters on. It's the death of them. Come get me. You know, them draws.
Nigga be like, oh, your brother on his way.
No.
He sit on the couch like this. Nigga sit on the couch looking like Dusty Rhodes.
Listen. He won't even see. Listen.
I got to put a picture of Dusty Rhodes up so y'all listen, know who he is. Because
he don't even.
You fucking with my sister. Dev like this.
Dev like this. No, Dev got the, what's the name?
Double listen. Apple grip.
Ain't no such thing as that.
No, double apple grip.
Here go Dev. Here go Dev.
Dev, wait for the Dev, nigga to swing. Dev, grab me my.
Dev, tell me. Dev, tell me.
Yo, come on, man.
Damn.
Choke out. Choke out. Choke out. Choke.
Listen, Dev, listen.
Yo,
Dev,
tell
the dude. Dev, dude, come to the door, Dev, like this. He's spraying the baby all over. He marked the line, pass that line. He got the baby all over, let's get it. He throw him the bottle, come on. He like, whoa, I'm cool. He like, he tell us this, keep me out of your shit. Don't call me over here in the woods. Slam the door, get the fuck out of there. Yo, he put the baby on himself, come on, you ready?
Why he put baby oil?
So you can't grip the motherfucker too much.
The thing is, niggas been caught doing shit like that, and they'll grease their legs so people can't get leg locked.
Was that some type of jail tactic?
No,
throw baby oil on so you can't get a good grip on him.
No.
They was doing it for different reasons.
Let me say this.
Let me find out every time.
They will wear that so that the jumpers came off faster. You know what I'm saying? The jumper just slide right off of
you. No, listen. A lot of times when dude was in the hole, like say a guard want to do a cell distraction, but they coming in with the shields on there, dudes just spray baby oil on the floor so when the guards try to come in there, they slip and fall, but nobody was doing that.
Well, they was on some cartoon shit.
That shit damn was doing.
These niggas was on some Tom and Jerry shit with the motherfucking guards.
Low was in there. They coming low cell, yo. Minnie Mike said he gonna stab the shit out you today when he see you. He did what? You watch yourself. You know Mike grabbed you first, and then he grabbed you.
Minnie Mike.
Nigga stripped out to his boxes.
Nigga like, when he grabbed me, he ain't gripping me up.
And that's how it be. These little niggas. Man, listen, you'll get to jail, right? You'll hear about somebody from back in the day. Your boy was a killer around the neighborhood. You get back in the day, you never seen no pussy. You be like, that's Killer Dave? That's Monster Dave?
Nigga be 134 pounds.
You like, that's the dude. And he up in there, you see him with a big ass boyfriend. Motherfucker 6'1". Bitch, sit down. You like, oh my God, this jail is real. I'm never saying that to nobody small in jail.
Knife is half his height, huh?
His knife bigger than him. He got a
He walked with his knife like a cane.
Yeah, nigga, what you say? Hey,
let's get into stories from the cell.
Stories from the cell. This story from the cell is brought to you by, have you had any good hair lately? I know I have. I'm going to get some more, too. Don't be ashamed in the game, but me and Gil got appointments set up from here all the way to Lifestop. Don't even worry about it. We're going to be, no, it's straight up special occasions. But I'm trying to do like birthdays, holidays, stuff like that. Valentine's Day, you know, shit like that. But I will say this story from the cell is once again brought to you by everythingdivaglam.com. Now, listen, this story from the cell is interesting. He's going to laugh at me because he remembered this. Gil come up to see me at a picnic. They had picnics in jail. Don't say nothing. Shut up. Let me finish it off. They got picnics in jail. Like, different organizations got picnics, lifers, Latinos. So he come out, I think it was the lifers picnic I paid to get on there. So you go out there, there's a big ass yard. So you go into one of the sides of the yards of the prison, your family coming and all this stuff. So everybody wanted to, you know, he come up, all the type of dudes said, oh, Gil, he hollering at him. I'm like, damn, I got to holler at him about some shit. You see what I'm saying? Because he walking around hollering at everybody, dudes want to kick, Gil, what's up, nigga? Dudes he ain't seen in 1,000 years. He come to jail, he's like, yo, he keep coming back to me like, the two niggas I was just talking to, I thought they got killed like in 90-something. They still alive. The niggas be disappearing, and they be in jail. You think they dead. He said, I thought them niggas was dead. I thought I went to one of them niggas' funeral. I said, no, you didn't go to one. So finally, the whole time, when he come up, he brought his girl up here to see me. So we kicking it. So by the time he finished walking all around, because I was sitting there kicking it before a minute, yeah, this and that, third. She's like, yeah, wow, Gil, bring me up. So I'm like, all right, cool. This, we kicking it. Boom, 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 eating a couple plates and shit. I'm getting some, knocking a couple plates off. So when I finally get to talk to him, it's about like 20 minutes left in the joint. Cause he, you know, I said, go ahead, cuz we talk on the phone, whatever, figure it out. So I get over there, he said, damn, anything cool, man? Just your thing. I'm like, yeah, anything cool, what's going on? This goofy motherfucker brung a chick up there for me with a dress on with no panties and nothing on. And he didn't tell me that until 20 minutes left in the fucking in the visit. I'm like, why the fuck you just tell? He said, nigga, you what the fuck? What you think she here for? Because this is a picnic where everybody be getting it in. The picnic, that, you know, that's where you can fuck. You know, that's where the guard turn their head. Dudes slide over there, act like they taking a picture. Slide the dress up.
Oh, the guards be looking out like that, yeah, huh?
The guards looking.
Roll.
Yeah. Well, that's the case, I guess. So listen, a lot of babies get made in prison from visits. But I'm like, now it got thinned out because a lot of people done left early because people trying to leave early, so they, you know, whatever. I'm like, why the fuck you just telling me? You went around and shook the 1,000 niggas' hands like you want to be in jail. Damn, my bro took 1,000 pictures. I'm like, that's when I realized he might have a little spiciness in him because he was posting up with too many pictures, giving out too many hugs in the prison yard.
on a visit. I'm like, yo, this nigga's gay on the low. I mean, which is that's his thing. No disrespect to gay people, but he just trying to act like he's not undercover brother. So I'm like, why the fuck you tell me at the end? So I'm mad as shit. So I go over there, put my mask on. I'm trying to figure it out. Like, if we get to join, but like all this, listen, you got dudes that used to come to the picnic. They didn't have nobody coming. All they did was stem. Like for the dick, like, cause the guard shifts change. So they might stand over there, talk to the guard. Yo, Ski, you need a plate? So they shilling the guard. Oh, okay,
got you. You told us about stemming before.
But a lot of them boys left. So I'm like, damn. So I'm just filling it up now and all that. Filling it up. Oh, yeah, I did. Yeah, you ready? You was lucky you ain't get this thing. This pipe, I'd have killed you, girl. This down third. She like, she just laughing like, nigga. I know she probably saying to herself, nigga, you supposed to have done that. That's what I'm here for. But this loser don't tell me that he brought the chicken.
First of all, you don't, first of all, I place a bitch in your hands. And walk off, go, oh, everybody, Gillie, I got it.
He didn't say nothing.
I am supposed to say something. She's sitting there talking, hey, she the nicest motherfucker in the world. He worrying about his big cuz. What the fuck is my cuz?
No, I ain't worrying about him. She
like,
I was talking to him.
She like, he look over, she got a titty on. He like this. Hey, bitch, see the way. Fuck is my cuz doing? My holiday,
so is you worried that he, because you tried to just no. accuse him of being gay, was you worried that he was taking pictures with niggas that you
like? No, he like this.
Because you got a John with you.
He like
naked,
this.
Damn
he
near.
Like this.
He done set
he
you up.
He like this. He like this. He like Ricky Minaj trying to take a picture with you.
Exactly. Yeah.
I knew Gil ain't taking pictures with Kevin the Stallion.
What? Hiana.
Kevin the Stallion.
Hey, oh shit! Hey, that was one of Sully's name, Kevin the Stallion.
No, he wasn't.
He was way before Megan.
No, the fuck he wasn't.
Craig the Stallion.
They said nigga was named Kevin the Stallion.
That's crazy. This nigga crazy. I just caught on it. I'm like,
his first selling was Kevin the Stallion.
That's crazy.
Megan Brothers.
Yo, that's crazy. But I was mad. I left. I called the nigga. I said, yo, why the fuck?
No, and as soon as we got in the car, she was like, I think your cousin is PP. I was like, what? She was like, I was rubbing him up the whole time. That joint ain't work.
What? PP?
Paralyzed penis.
Oh, man.
She's like, I rubbed him up. That motherfucker ain't do a jump or nothing. That motherfucker just laid there. I said, yeah.
He ain't have his sleeve on.
He ain't have his prison sleeve.
Yeah,
prison maid sleeve.
Hey, listen, man, I'm going to tell you some real shit, man. It's like, at the end of the day, it's like, yo, I'm probably happy because she probably had the baby, Bobby. She ain't no kids, nothing. He's like, yo, she nice peoples, man. She seen the picture of you. I said, oh, man, I'm cool. I'm cool, though.
I'd rather go back to my cell and jerk off. I don't want no pussy.
That was crazy, man.
Take me to my cell. You cuss me out because I dare you bring a bitch up here to give me some pussy. Fuck is wrong with you? Don't ever do that shit ever again, cuz.
All right,
my fault, cuz. I ain't trying. I try to get your dick off the shelf. You want your dick on the prison shelf. All right, cool. Hey, listen, man. This is $1 million worth of game. We appreciate y'all.
We love y'all.
Tuning in each and every week.
We love y'all.
We should come up with some shit like how Russell used to do with Def Jam. Remember, I used to always end it off. All right, everybody, good night.
Good night. God bless you. Love you, sugar. Night, night.
That was dry as shit, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, Russell.
Yeah, y'all got y'all shit. Y'all know y'all shit.
Yeah, we say what we say. It's cool.
Oh, we say what we say?
Yeah.
Thank you for tuning in. And it's just like that.
Right!